Meantime, tens of thousands of gun owners in California are in legal limbo tonight because of the state's newly expanded assault weapons ban.
Only on 5, Alan Martin found out it has to do with delays in implementing the law, delays no one wants to take responsibility for.
For years, ARs have been the weapon of choice at this gun store and shooting range in Vacaville.
Everybody wanted them right then.
But owner Travis Morgan says this year, it's different.
Nobody's sure what the law's going to be, how it's going to be, when it's going to be written, what you got to register. So they all kind of just slowed down buying.
That's because a new law makes many of the guns he once sold and that many of his customers still use illegal. Until this year, AR rifles equipped with so-called bullet buttons were exempt from California's assault weapons ban, even though they have a detachable magazine along with all the features of a military-style gun. That's because you need a tool, usually a bullet, to release the magazine rather than just the push of a finger, making them slower to reload. But that didn't slow down the San Bernardino shooters in December of 2015. Armed with modified bullet button ARs, they managed to gun down 36 people in the span of 3 minutes. So lawmakers in Sacramento took action, closing what the Department of Justice now calls a loophole in the law. Now, bullet button ARs are considered assault weapons. They can no longer be bought or sold, although there's an exemption for people who lawfully owned them before the beginning of the year.
Because this law had been out before. And last time, Mr. Brown vetoed it. This time he didn't. He's a lame duck this season. He can't run again. So he signed it.
There are thousands, if not tens of thousands, of legally owned ARs in California right now. But beginning January 1st, an AR with a bullet button is either going to have to be modified or registered with the state to remain legal. The problem is, you can't even register an AR right now.
They don't know how to implement these laws.
Craig DeLuce is with the Firearms Policy Coalition, a group that lobbies for gun owner rights in California. He says the new law requires the DOJ to come up with new regulations before it can open up an electronic registration system. But so far, the agency has failed to do that. That is leaving law-abiding gun owners who want to register but can't in a catch-22.
At the very end of December, on the eve of New Year's Eve, they tried to sneak the regulations past the public through the administrative process with no public input whatsoever. When they found out that they weren't going to be able to get away with that, they pulled them back.
But this man says it's the other way around.
Fortunately, the gun lobbies used their typical delay tactics.
Ari Freilich with the Law Center to Prevent Gun Violence helped craft the new law. He blames pushback from the gun lobby, including threats of lawsuits, for the delay.
The California legislature specifically passed a law in the assault weapon law to say that California's Department of Justice doesn't have to go through the rigmarole of public comment and red tape every time they want to develop regulations about registering assault weapons.
This is Attorney General Alan Martin.
We caught up with Attorney General Javier Becerra, the man in charge of implementing the state's new assault weapons law, at a recent speaking event.
A lot of gun owners are complaining they can't register them, and the holdup is within your office. How do you answer those complaints?
We will issue regulations. They have been a little delayed, and because of the transition in attorneys general, it did take a little longer. But we're going to make sure that the process is one that is respectful of responsible gun owners.
Back in Vacaville, Travis isn't holding his breath, and he says neither are his customers.
A lot of guys gone towards a featureless gun.
He now sells modified ARs. Stripped of military-style features like a collapsible stock, flash suppressor, or forward pistol grip, they are no longer considered assault weapons.
Yeah, that way you don't have to register it, you ain't got to do nothing, you're done.
In Vacaville, Alan Martin, KPIX 5.
Alan says there's late word from Sacramento that the registration deadline will most likely be pushed back to July of 2018.